This video was sponsored by Wargaming's very own World of Tanks War Stories. That's right, Billy! Even you can play this very scenario with tanks in an online experience. Want to find out more? Well, find out after this video, Billy!
In 1861, Richard Gatling invented a weapon. A gun that by simply turning the crank could provide the firepower of 40 men and kill just as many too. Gatling's purpose for making it was simple. If a weapon is so destructive, it will be a deterrent that will terrify nations from going to war. Gatling, however, was proven wrong, as his invention was used by the Union against the rebels just a year later. Conflict simply became more destructive. The end still justified the means, no matter the death toll. Gatling's philosophy eventually came true. It just wasn't for his weapon. Nuclear bombs are so devastating, they became the deterrent instead of his gun. The fear of total destruction forces countries away from that military option that could have occurred centuries prior, and that's why we're in the longest era of peace in human history. However, there have been certain times where that Gatling gun was almost used. For 2 weeks in 1962, there was such utter confusion in the tension, it appeared like the ends did justify the means. The Soviets were secretly building missile sites in Cuba. To the United States, this was unacceptable. In an age where ICBMs couldn't travel the entire world, these close missiles now meant millions of Americans were vulnerable. Even though the US had missiles in Turkey, this was apparently an issue. And it was one that seemed the Americans were ready to fight over. The Cuban Missile Crisis was the closest humanity has come to extinction. That cannot be overstated. The answer to this video's title is pretty obvious. There is only one outcome that can result from the missile crisis escalating: total nuclear war. This video isn't meant to change that outcome. If the US did retaliate against Castro or the Soviets, it's inevitable the nukes would fly and millions would die with it. This scenario is about the few days of conflict before the world ends. The missile crisis lasted 13 days. Every single hour counted. This is a video about the last days of human civilization that easily could have been, but never was. It is an alternate October 1962. Intelligence reveals that the Soviets have been working with the communist Castro regime to install nuclear missile silos. These have a range which can hit anywhere in the US, excluding Seattle. President Kennedy immediately forms a team of advisors called XCOM. Kennedy faced a room of advisors pressing him into one thing. The only way to secure American safety is a full-scale invasion to bring down those missile sites. In our history, the myth that the Kennedys stayed level-headed while the military generals advised otherwise is simply half true. Literally, only one Kennedy stayed level-headed and waited for more information. In recent declassified tapes of the events, Bobby Kennedy, contrary to his depiction in his own book 13 Days, was an adamant war hawk. He wanted nothing more than revenge against Castro for the Bay of Pigs, and he was vocal about using military force to bring down the missile sites. In this alternate timeline, there isn't much that needs to change. All that has to happen is the president has some bad judgment. John F. Kennedy gives into the opinions of his brother and everybody else. He authorizes a full-scale invasion of Cuba to neutralize the missiles and overthrow Castro. Today we view this plan as insane, and while they were, there was some logic to it, but not really. Intelligence showed that Cuba only had one mobile nuke, and as long as the Cubans didn't use any nukes against the Americans, the plan would be fine. Now, if they did, then Cuba would be obliterated in atomic flame. Hopefully it didn't come to that. The hope was the invasion would keep the conflict limited, and World War III would simply not occur. But for now, they would implement a blockade. The blockade is less of a deterrent and more to buy time as the invasion is prepared. The preparations would take about a week. In the meantime, the Air Force is put on maximum readiness posture as B-47s are readied. Mobilization has begun. The United States public by this time has been informed of the crisis, but they don't know any plans are already in effect. In an effort to not cause any social unrest, the American South isn't informed about any potential nuclear missiles headed their way if the conflict gets out of hand. The military movement is explained as a defense against Cuban aggression. The estimated death toll for American forces in the first week is roughly 20,000, assuming no nukes are used. Negotiations break down and the invasion plan is implemented. By late October, American forces reach the coast of Cuba. They invade from the north. Whether this was to be a surprise attack, an American Pearl Harbor, or one where the Soviets are informed, was one of debate among XCOM. Either way, the Cubans are overwhelmed. American bombing campaigns target the missile sites as an amphibious landing takes place on the beaches outside Havana. The world is utterly shocked at what has occurred. 60,000 Soviet troops are on the Cuban island at the time of the attack. Kennedy appears on the air, announcing the threat the missiles pose to American peace and stability. He says Castro has shown that he is willing to harm his neighbors. Purposefully, the aim is used at blaming Castro, so the Soviets are meant to have a way out of the conflict. Meanwhile, any Cuban resistance is swept aside. The armored invasion force spreads out across the north, most go east to Havana. What I would imagine is that the Americans would face barely any Cubans as the days go on. The United States is confident that the Cubans are going to surrender, as defense is small and... Thousands of Americans are vaporized in an instant. The Cubans didn't just have one nuclear launcher. They, along with the Soviets, had 100 tactical nukes the Americans knew nothing about. The invasion force of the United States is simply trapped as tactical nukes are used against their positions. Plan B is implemented, nuclear bombings on Cuba. Now the invasion force is trapped as both sides exchange nukes. Immediately, traditional warfare becomes obsolete within the first couple days. For the general public, news would be coming around every hour. If you were a civilian in the United States, you'd hear news of Soviet tanks crossing into Berlin. But then, the news would stop. The bombs would start falling as the Soviets retaliate. By the end of the conflict, using the capabilities of American and Soviet forces, the United States would technically win the war. 100 million Americans would have died, only 80 million at most would remain. The Soviets would face American bombers and Jupiter missiles. The entire country would be obliterated. Ultimately, past this point, there really isn't much of a history to report anymore. The nuclear exchange obliterated human society, or at least most of it. Those that do survive would face nuclear winter and constant starvation. John F. Kennedy, if he is remembered by future generations, would be remembered as the man who pushed the button. His obsession over Cuba would be his legacy. The war was his conflict. And his personal vendetta against Castro ended the world. This video was sponsored by World of Tanks War Stories. For those that don't know what World of Tanks is, it's an online multiplayer game where you command a single tank against 30 other players, also in tanks. There are over 450 historically accurate World War II tanks from two decades you can pick. It regularly updates and continuously has new stuff. And best of all, it's free to play, and on all PS4 and Xbox One consoles, so you can get into it easy. Now they've introduced War Stories Kennedy's War. It's a story-driven alternate history campaign where the missile crisis was the start to the end of everything. So for Alternate History Hub viewers, in celebration of the release of War Stories, they have a special offer for new players who sign up. By clicking the link below, you can grab your free tank, garage slot, and 3 days of premium game time while this lasts. The number of registration codes is limited, so sign up while you can. This is Cody of Alternate History Hub.